Hello, it's Sue here, your Look Fabulous Forever Ambassador. I'm going out to lunch today, so I want to make the most of my makeup. I've already put on my cleanse my face, and I've put on this moisture whole serum, which I really like. Hydration whole face serum. I've followed it up with my day cream, and I've used my Smooth Like Silk face primer. And I've used my foundation. So what you're looking at now is just like a blank canvas that I'm going to put my makeup on top of. So bear with me, I've not rehearsed anything, so I've no idea how this is going to turn out, but I'll do my best. Don't forget your mirror, Susan. Right. So I'm going to start with concealer. I use concealer 2, and I've got dark shadows around my eyes. And a little bit of discoloration here. So I'm going to apply that first. I'm going to dab it on with my fingers initially, and then I might blend with a brush. Can you see the difference? It's already sort of, I think, opened my eyes up a little bit. Got rid of those shadows. You only need a tiny dot. Blend it in well. I've got a little sort of red dot there that I like to try and cover. Although we've all got our imperfections, haven't we? That's what makes us unique. And then I like to put a little bit around my nose. For some reason I've got a little bit of redness there, don't know why. And round like that. Does that make sense? Does that look okay? I've got a more even skin tone now. So that's done. And then before I do anything else, I want to put my eye prime on because that needs just a little bit of time to sit before you put your eye makeup on. So again, I'm using my fingers, tiny dot. Sort of pat it in, dot it around, and here too. So we're going out to lunch. It's a friend's birthday, so it's quite a posh lunch, and we're going to a golf club. It's always nice to have something special, isn't it, to look forward to. So I'm just going to leave that to settle a little bit while I work on the rest of me. And not everybody does it in this order. But I do like to get my lips lined. Just gives me a definition, I think. Makes me more confident. Right, there we are. I feel better already. There. So that's the strawberry lip liner, my favourite. And then I'm going to use. I know a lot of you use Bring Back the Brow, but I like the taupe eye pencil and I use that for my eyebrows. So I'm going to put my eyebrows on. Just dab with short strokes to fill in any gaps. I'm quite lucky, I think, that I've still got my brows. But they are getting quite sparse and they do define your face, aren't they? I once heard somebody say they're like the coat hangers for your face, but I don't want them so dark, so I'm going to just use this spoolie brush. There, can you see how it's just blended that in to give a more natural look? Okay, so lips lined, eyebrows on, so that's a good start. I think my eyelid primer. Is setting, which is great. But before we do anything else, I'm just going to put some translucent powder over what I've put on already, just to give it a light dusting, especially that T panel down the middle. And on my forehead, because I'll probably get excited and get hot, especially if the we're drinking wine and singing happy birthday. So that's the translucent powder that I've just brushed over to set what I've put on already. That's good, I'm happy with that. And then what am I going to do next? I think the next thing I'll do is put some of this lip primer around my lips. That's just to stop your lipstick bleeding into any lines that you have around there. And I've got one particularly nasty line there from years of worry. When I used to chew my lips like that. If I knew then what I knew now, I wouldn't have bothered so much and I would have saved myself some of these crinkles, as my granddaughter calls them. There, that's the Nether Feather lip primer and it just stops your lipstick moving. Got the lip liner on as well, so that's a double security. Right, next I'm going to do my eyes, I think. And the first thing I'm going to do is line. I line the inside of my eyes and I'm going to use that with the dark brown pencil liner. Lovely and soft these, so I'm not going to hurt my eyes at all. And I just look up and do the rim of that eye just to give it some definition. I've got very, very fine pale eyelashes and you can't see that I've got any at all when I haven't got mascara on. But I think that just lines there. I'll be putting my eyeliner on later. And I'm wearing this. So I think I might go for the pale greys eyeshadow and I've got the trio here. Soft greys it's called. And it looks like that. So I'm going to be working with those three colours. And recently I've enjoyed putting my eyeshadow on with a foam tipped applicator. I just think it's quicker for me. I know some of you are very, very good with brushes, but I tend to get it everywhere. So I'm going to use this. I will use a brush for blending. So I just rub it into the paler shade first, the lighter grey, and I push it into, can you see, the inside edges of my eye. There we go. I'm trying to be quick. I'm not succeeding. Anyway, there I go. And stretch it along. There. And then I take the middle colour. It says grey, but it's quite a mauvey shade of grey. It's quite pretty. And I'm going to put that here. Towards the outer edges. That's so far so good. And then I take the cream. I've got the single cream and I've got it in the soft neutrals. So I'm going to take my cream and I'm going to use a brush this time. And I'm going to brush it up here on my brow bone. You see, to give a matte look. It just lifts your eye. And do this side the same. And what I'm also going to do is take the taupe from my soft neutrals palette and I just put a little bit in the outer just to give more definition here. I find the very dark grey a bit dark and I use this taupe a lot as a single or in the palettes because it just works for me, I suppose. And I suppose that's what putting your makeup on is all about, finding out what works for you. There. And I think that's my eyeshadow mostly done. What I'll do now is do my eyeliner and I thought I'd use the new navy one today, the dark blue. And I'm just going to draw a line close to my eye. I think it complements with the grey. Right, I need a little bit of sheen or a lighter touch in the centre. So for that, I think I'll use this pink and cream from this palette and just put a little dot, can you see, in the centre? It just gives it a lift. Right, I think that's mostly my eyeshadows done. What next, Susan? Right, I think what I'll do now is put my bronzer on. I use the bronzer as a contourer, really, and to add some colour. So it looks like that. Looks very dark, but it doesn't go on dark at all. It just gives you that sun-kissed look. It along a little bit along my jawline, just add a touch really, and then what I like to do is take a bigger brush, one like this, and see if I can contour a little bit underneath. Now I wouldn't have to do this, there was a time I didn't have to do this because I had cheekbones. Then I discovered pork pies. Oh, and I think that might have slimmed down my face a little bit. Do you agree? So that's done. And then just here where I've put the bronzer on, I'm just going to use a little bit of, this is called Coral Pop, just on my the top of my cheekbones. You see I'm using very little, just to add what I hope is a natural flush to my face. That. And then I'm going to take my highlighter pen, give it a shake. And I always put a little bit on my, press the top down, I always put a little bit on my hand first, like that. Because you don't want a lot, you don't want to use a lot. And see, you just dot it round. And blend it lightly, just to add, just so that the light will catch the top of that bone there and hopefully make me sparkle. And then I use a little bit here underneath my brow bone again, hoping that will lift my eye. Gosh, I'm nearly there. Next, what I haven't done is put on my mascara. So I'm going to use the Live Lash mascara. I always sort of make it sparse on the brush before I start. And I'm now going to have to look in my mirror for this, otherwise I'll get it everywhere. It's a great mascara because it stays put, stays where you put it. So many mascaras actually start off looking grand and then before you, well, you know, they're under your eyes, but this one actually stays where it's supposed to. I'm going to pause right now so I can finish this off. Okay, so you can see that's my lashes done. And what I did do in the interval was find my Sheer Brilliance lid colour. And I've just put, can you see, a little dab on each eye, tiny, tiny spot, blend it. And it just gives a little bit of lustre to the centre of your eye, you know, which makes your eyes pop. Well, I think it does. So that's done. Where am I now? I think the only thing I've got to do is touch my bottom lashes. I didn't do that. And put my lipstick on. Now let's have a go. I really just brush my lashes like that with the end of this. You see they're there, but you just can't see them till they get mascara on them. There we go. I already feel a lot better. And then my lipstick. Now my poppy lipstick, which is this one, which I love, but it's become quite rounded at the end. So I'm actually going to use a brush to put this on. Then I can get, I think when you're wearing a brighter lipstick, you need to be more accurate. I tend to hop between coral, I think it's true coral, poppy, foxy lady. But I think today's a poppy day. So that's the poppy lipstick. And then I just use this cinnamon, gorgeous gloss lip shine in cinnamon. Looks like that. Smells like cinnamon. And I just put a little bit in the center of my lips to give it some fullness, give them fullness. And I, on my eyes, I put a little bit of green just here in the inner rim of my eye. And I think that's my makeup done, ladies. Take these curlers out that I used to give my hair a little bit of oomph. Get my earrings in. I remember reading, I think it was the Queen Mother who always said, pearls for lunch, diamonds for dinner. So I'm putting my pearls on and I'm getting quite excited now, nearly ready. A for away, as they say. Well, it would be if I could get my pearls on. And there I am, all ready for lunch. I hope you found it interesting. If you have enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up, give it a like, comment, because it's those likes and comments that LFF, Look Fabulous Forever, rely on to get the word out there about their product. Well, I hope you have a lovely lunch. What do you think? Bye for now.